Alright, what's up, y'all? Welcome back to another video. In this video, we'll be working on the budget build, of course. Last video, we did all kinds of stuff to the rear end, seat, fender, electronics box, stuff like that. In this video, I want to attack the front, so I want to install new handlebars, a gauge, headlight, grips. I want to do some stuff with the front fender as well. But before we do anything, I think it's a good idea to tear the front apart, give us a little bit more space. Let's get straight to it. Alright, so we're done with tearing the front apart. It's always a little bit of a mystery what you are going to find in the headlight. It wasn't too bad. I feel it's mostly just the stock wiring, so that's good. So when we hold a diagram next to it in the future, that's probably fine. But the previous owner did change a couple of wires. For instance, this one, it's just, they're all black. How much are these? 1, 2, 3, 4. 8 black wires and 3 brown wires. 8 black wires. I'm not really sure how we're going to figure that out, but they did still use the previous connector with, and I'm hoping these are the right color, so we can figure that out when we want to attach our gauge and our dummy lights and stuff like that. So that is a bit annoying. Other than that, the wiring is way too long that we or way longer than we're going to need, but I guess we'll figure that out. I think right now would be a good idea to basically do some mocking up. So the first thing I want to do is put the new handlebars on, see how that looks. And once we have that on there, we can check where our gauge should sit and our ignition switch and possibly our headlight as well. So let's throw these handlebars on. All right, probably something like that. So that we have our new gauge right here. Still has this protective film on here. We're not gonna worry about that right now. I'm not even sure whether I'm actually going to use this holder. Because if we put it right here, I think that would look pretty good, but it is kind of off to the side, so maybe it would be nicer if we make something ourselves and have it in the middle, but then we would have to decide where we are going to put our ignition switch. So that's something we got to think about. So from a rider's position, I guess it would basically look something like this. We have our gauge right here. We can put it right here, but I feel it's a bit far out. So we could shave this down a bit, make a new hole so that it would be a little bit closer. But something like this would look pretty cool too. Only downside to that would be that we have to figure out where we are going to put our ignition switch. And also it's nice like this, but yeah, we don't actually know whether we can actually see it whilst riding. Let's see whether I can take a seat on this thing. It would look pretty good, but it's a whole lot more effort like this. Right, let's think about that. All right, so I decided that I do like the asymmetrical look of this being on the left side of the bike. But two things that I don't like, that it is sticking too far out and a little bit too high. So I think I'm going to try and bend this the bracket on here. See if we can bring it down and in just a little bit. So let's put it in our vise, give it a couple of bends, put it back on here again, see whether that looks any better. All right, okay, I don't like it, we'll make something ourselves. This just looks not good. I was hoping maybe we could get away with doing it like this and saving ourselves an hour. Just looks like crap, so we're not gonna do it. We'll make a nice little bracket for it ourselves. We're definitely gonna keep this for some dimensions, but this just doesn't look very good. All right, so we decided that this bracket isn't going to work. Not very surprised by the way I tried to bend it, but yeah, it's just the gauge is still sticking out a little bit too far. So I guess we're going with the idea before that, which is having the gauge in the middle. So that means that we have to make our own bracket. I am going to keep this because we know this is an easy way to measure our distance, or actually not having to measure the distance between the bolts and the back. So we have to come up with a way to mount it to our bike. So we're going to put these two dots down. All right, and this is like a V almost, right? So you have it like this. So my idea would be that we would make something that would actually go along the top side, so we don't have to worry about interfering with our wiring here or even our speedo cable in the future. So almost like one of those tools that you use to adjust your springs. So basically something like this, and then yeah, well, basically something like this, and then we'll have a hole right here to attach it to our triple tree, these two holes to attach our gauge again. I think that would look pretty neat. We can hide most of it because it's not going to be very pretty, but I think something like this would be a pretty good idea. So I have to take some quick measurements on where that middle would be and where exactly our triple tree mount would be. So I'm going to take a quick measurement. So this is 10.5 centimeters. Now we want our gauge to sit in the middle of that. We know the middle of 10.5 is 5.25. So now we have to measure our bolt distances. All right, so this is what I drawed earlier. So our forks, or triple tree, whatever you want to call it. These 10.5 centimeters, or these three dots, resemble this part of our triple tree. 4.5. So that means from our dot in the middle at 5.25 centimeters, on each side we'd have to add 2.25. Now the bolts on the back of our gauge should line up with this. When I hold it against it like this, I think this will match up. So now we have that. All right. Let's cut it out. Right, so our little piece is done, or it's cut. As you can see, it's kind of wonky. I will definitely fix that in the future, but with some more grinding, but I just really want to check whether this will actually work or not. So let's put it on the bike and see how it looks. Right, as you can see, it's back on again. Maybe it's not 100% in the middle, but definitely close enough. I feel like this looks pretty good. I would say your head would be around here somewhere. So as you can see all the dummy lights and your gauge pretty well. So I'm very happy with that. All in all, pretty good. Wasn't that much work. It worked out in one go. So I'm very happy with that. All right. So we definitely still have to shave this down a little bit to make it look a little bit more neat. And of course, we will be painting it black so it will fade away a little bit more. So next up would be our headlight, and I kind of like that they're matching, as in we have this black and shiny theme going on. Some of it's chrome, some of it's polished, some of it's probably fake like this headlight, but looks pretty good. I think this combination as well looks pretty neat as well. I'm thinking we put our headlight right around here. So what I basically, let me show you like this. So what I basically want to do is have a plate right here. Cut this to size, weld that to this plate, and then our headlight should be on there. So that should be pretty easy. Let's do it. Right, the bracket is on and finished, as in this is basically its final form, except for sanding it down and painting it. Added a little plate on the bottom right here to give it a little bit more rigidity. This is what it looks like from the side. To be honest, I don't think it looks very good, but with how shitty this headlight is, I feel like this is the amount of effort I'm willing to spend on putting this headlight on here. I do think once we paint our bracket mounting thing black, I think it'll look fine, and yeah, would that definitely be good enough. So that's time that we move on to the next thing. Next thing I want to do is actually the forks. There's not a whole lot of other stuff that we have to do to the triple trees, I think. So basically I want to put it back together. But these lowers, they're very crusty. I mean, they're dirty and they got a bunch of deep scratches in it. I don't have enough paint, or I think budget, to buy a bunch of paint. So I am going to try and give these a polish. I don't really feel like sanding them. That would probably be best. That would be the way to go to fix these up as good as possible, but I don't feel like it. We still have a bunch of other stuff left to do after this, so I'm just going to try and polish them as well as I can with my polisher. Hopefully that'll make them shine a bit more and look heaps better. All right, so unfortunately, polishing these lowers with the state they're in is, well, you can do it, but it's just completely pointless. Actually, tried polishing this part right here. And as you can see, you can't see it at all. It's still super scratchy. So we're going to have to figure out whether we want to sand it all the way up to a point where it's actually polishable, or sand it and paint it. The polishing part would be free, but probably would cost a whole lot of more time. And the painting wouldn't be free, of course, but it would save a lot of time. So I'm not really sure what I want to do. For now, I think I'll just slap him in the bike and start tackling something else. In the meantime, we'll think about what would be the best idea for this. So we'll just put him back right now, start working on something else. Still have a bunch of other stuff left to do, so not to worry. We'll figure out later what's the best thing to do. Right, forks are back on, we got the wheel in there. Didn't put the spacers in between or the brake on and stuff like that because we will be taking it off again. But what I want to focus on right now is our front fender. And as you can see, this point exactly in the middle is starting to rot, or has rotten almost completely away actually. But the good part of that is that the inside hasn't yet. I want to reuse the bracket mount, what would you call this? The part that the fender attaches to catch the water from the front wheel. I want to reuse this part and a good part of the fender. So this is basically what it sits like stock. So it's very close to the wheel. I like that. I think that looks very good. Obviously, the size, or at least in my opinion, it's way too big. And the part that's completely rotting away, obviously doesn't look very good. So what I was thinking is we cut basically the front part that's still in, well, decent condition, and the rear lip. After that, after we did, we've done that, I guess we would weld them together so we have a complete fender again. So with the nice lip, because I think that looks good. Weld those together. Somehow detach the mounting thing from the fender. And then attach that, probably just by welding it to the bracket again. And then we should have a kind of OEM plus fender, I guess. So nice and tucked, short. Still very close to the wheel, but not as gigantic and without the rotting part. Let's cut this thing up. Right, so we made our cuts for the fender. I think this looks pretty good. This size and cuts seem to line up pretty well. So if we weld this together, grind my ugly weld down and polish it a bit, I think it'll look fine. So I'm very happy with that. So what we got to do right now is take this brace thing out of here. I think it's just those rivets. So I think if we grind off these things right here, we should be able to break it out. So let's give that a try. So as you can see, our fender is cut. I put the bracket back with just the two bolts. The top of it is a little rusty, but still very solid, so that should be good. And I got kind of lucky whilst cutting the fender, because it lines up pretty well, actually. I think this looks really good. I think it matches the bike. It's, I think if we somehow are able to hide my welds good enough, I think it looks, I wouldn't say stock, but doesn't look like a cut up fender anymore. At least that's my goal for this fender. Let's try and weld this thing together. All right, we're done welding, or at least for now. This fender is super thin, definitely less than half a millimeter. And that's about how small my welder will go. So as you can see, welds are definitely not perfect. As you can see right here, it started, as you can see right here, it kind of started off all right, but yeah, pretty rough. I think we can smooth this part down a little bit more. Probably add a couple more welds to fill some holes, but as I was welding, I was constantly burning holes because it was just too hot. But I'm going to try and fill this in as best as possible, but forgetting how the weld looks for now, the entire fender in total, I think that looks pretty good. I think that worked out great. So I put the bracket in between the forks right now. As you can see, it's very loose, but if we put this on here, I think this is very neat. My girlfriend thinks it looks very goofy. I do like it, so we don't really have another option anyway because we already cut the fender up, so it is what it is. I think it looks very good. So what I'm going to try and do now is fix this weld on the back of the fender as best as possible. After that, we'll weld it to our bracket right here. And after that, our fender is done. All right, so I was working on our fender and I was trying to get rid of the obvious welds on the fender. As you can see, that didn't work out too good. But I remembered I had one of those polishing type of discs for an angle grinder. This thing right here. And I remember somebody told me, like, if you want to get rid of your welds, this is super good for it. And, well, in my experience, that's not totally true, or at least not with this weld. But I did notice that I was able to get a lot of really deep scratches out of this thing. And that got me thinking, well, maybe if it works for that, maybe it'll work for the forks and we can actually polish our forks and have them look at least kind of decent. So I gave it a shot and was like, well, if we fuck it up, it doesn't really matter anyway, because otherwise we're going to paint them. So I gave it a shot. It looks like this right now. As you can see, it looks, well, at least in my opinion, really good. It's got definitely a little bit of a, what do you call it? A reflection in it. So I think that looks really good, especially if you compare it to the old one. It's super grimy and know whether the camera will pick it up, but you can see lots of super deep scratches here, for instance. No more scratches on this one. This one looks really good, so I'm very happy that I tried it. If I didn't try it, they would be painted. I guess that would be kind of good as well, but would be basically the same amount of work, and this is what I had in mind. So we're going to polish this one right now and our fender, of course. After that, we'll slap it together and it should look pretty good. All right, as you can see, the front is completely back together again. We got our fender on as well. Fitment is looking pretty good. Seems to be pretty straight, so I'm happy with that. I did have to sand down the chrome off of it because it was very spotty. So some parts were mirror-like and other parts weren't. I think this looks pretty good. So it's a little bit less shiny than it was, but still looking pretty good. Seems to match the fork lowers pretty nice. As you can see, this weld right here, still not very pretty. It's basically how much I felt comfortable with taking off, because I don't want to take so much off that it becomes fragile. This seems good. Oh, it's actually still loose on there. But as you can see, this won't go anywhere, so that's good. In the meantime, I did all the wiring as well, so the headlight and our gauge is wired up, and I tried my best to clean this up as much as possible. Still lots of cables, but it looks pretty organized, so definitely good enough. Decided to get rid of the pull cable in our throttle. It was it wasn't really working all that well anyway. It kept on falling out, so decided to get rid of it. Still works, as you can see, so that's fine. So basically all that's left right now is to put some grips on these handlebars, and then our front end should be complete. Right, as you can see, it's really starting to look like a bike again. I actually really am starting to like this bike. Yeah, like I said in earlier videos, it's just the fact that we're just building it for $500. It takes a little bit pressure off of it, just having a little bit more fun. And I'm definitely having fun with this build so far. So that's of course very good for me at least. Yeah, like I said, I'm very happy with the way that it's turning out. Looking good. Of course, definitely still a lot of stuff to do. Also haven't decided yet what I'm going to do for mirrors. I don't know whether there'll be a budget to install new mirrors, or if we are going to reuse the old ones. Personally, I wouldn't even want a mirror on here, but it is required by Dutch law to have at least one mirror on the left side. And I do also kind of prefer riding with a mirror on there. So it's good to see whether you have any cost behind you or not. Okay, so at the end of every video, we talk a little bit about the money that we've spent so far and how far we are on our budget. So the previous total was $331.13. And in this video, we bought a couple of things. Grips, handlebars, speedo, and a headlight. The grips are really cheap, €5.27. All AliExpress stuff, so not super surprised. I was surprised with the fact that they actually weren't closed off. Fortunately, the handlebar had like these black end caps on it, so it looks kind of natural, so I'm good with that. So yeah, the grips were $5.27. Next up were the handlebars, and didn't buy those off AliExpress. I figure handlebars are some is a part that you want not to break. So but those of another website, these feel pretty sturdy. The price was €38.95, so still pretty cheap. They're nothing special, so wouldn't expect them to be more expensive than this, but seem pretty solid. Price pretty solid as well. Next up we have our speedo, which is €15.17. All the dummy lights and backing lighting and the speedo seem to be working, so that's good. One thing that is a bit unfortunate is that the neutral light and the oil light, the indicator lights, they use the same ground wire. And perhaps on some other bikes that I don't know, that's not really that big of a deal, but the signal for neutral and for your oil pressure on these bikes actually is the ground wire. So it's either or in this case. So I decided to go with the neutral light. I'm confident that this engine will keep its oil pressure. And the idea is to actually sell this bike, and neutral lights is usually something people really want to have on their bike. So I decided to go with that. Yeah, so the speedo was €15.17. Keep on looking that way because of the prices written down right there. Headlight is €19.61. Looking pretty good. Was hoping it would look a little bit better, or feel at least a little bit less flimsy, but if you buy stuff off AliExpress, you can kind of expect what you're getting. So not too surprised, so I'm not disappointed. So that means that the total for this video is 79 euros. So that leaves us with a total spent of 410.13. So basically 90 euros left to spend. Not a lot, but as you can see, we don't need a lot anymore. We need some pot filters, and I definitely want to put a different muffler on here. This thing is just gigantic and doesn't sound very good. I'm not sure how much that stuff is going to cost. We'll figure that out as we go along, but if we have some left, maybe we'll buy some mirrors or stuff like that. We also have to paint our subframe, of course. And I keep on forgetting that we still have to put new shocks on here, so I'm curious as to how we're going to figure that out budget-wise, but find out on the next episode. For now, I want to thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching, and if you did, I hope you'll subscribe. And yeah, I'll see you at the next one.